actually.
A very special occasion in joining Lisa and Alex in the union of marriage. Alex, you may now receive your bride and walk her forward, please. It will work. Perfect, thank you.
Okay.
Now, first off, let me congratulate the two of you for taking this step into marriage. The two of you have each had a separate path that has led you not only to each other, but to this very moment. And the unity candle will represent exactly that later on in the ceremony, how your two individual lives will now become one through marriage. And if there's a few other things that I hope would carry along its way with the two of you throughout your journey together, it would be for you both to always be willing from the heart to listen, learn, and to love. And by that I simply mean for you both to always be willing to listen to one another, what it is that they have to offer, and what it is that makes them feel whole, complete, and part of this relationship, this marriage that the two of you are now creating. Because after all, they just may be the voice of reason. And secondly, is the ability to learn. Now, no matter what point in time, always be willing to learn whatever it takes to help the other fulfill every desire, every wish, every dream and goal that they may have. And lastly, but most importantly, is the ability to love. To love one another unconditionally. Which means no strings attached. It's an ongoing love. And this is the type of love that I hope the two of you would wish to express to one another each and every day. Keeping in mind, Alex, that Lisa's happiness will always be far more important than your own. And also, Lisa, that Alex's happiness will be more important than yours. And the reason for that is, with that in your minds and in your hearts, I have no doubt that your lives together will be everything that you want it to be. So with that said, sir, I'll ask you first. With your presence here today, alongside Lisa, do you take her as your wife in promising to love, honor, cherish, and respecting her always, allowing nothing or no one to ever come between the two of you? Do you take her as your wife, sir?
I do.
Thank you, Alex. And Lisa, I'll ask you the same. With your presence here today, alongside Alex, do you take him as your husband in promising to love, honor, cherish, and respecting him always, allowing nothing or no one to ever come between the two of you? Do you take him as your husband?
Oh, I do.
That's a very wonderful answer. Thank you, Lisa. And I'll ask for you to hand over your bouquet. And if the two of you would please turn to face each other and hold each other's hands. Now, Alex and Lisa, as you look into each other's eyes, you will see the very reason of what brought you here this evening. Proving that at this moment, there is no one more important than who stands before you. So, Alex, in looking into her eyes, I'll have you repeat your vows. I, Alex, take you, Lisa.
I, Alex, take you, Lisa.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
I will always be there for you.
I will always be there for you.
Through the good times and the bad.
Through the good times and the bad.
Whether we are rich or poor.
Whether we are rich or poor.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
Through laughter and tears.
Through laughter and tears.
I will love and cherish you.
I will love and cherish you.
I give you my pledge.
I give you my pledge.
Thank you, Alex. And Lisa, as you look into his eyes, I'll have you repeat your vows. I, Lisa, take you, Alex.
I, Lisa, take you, Alex.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
I will always stand beside you.
I will always stand beside you.
Through success and misfortune.
Through success and misfortune.
Through the joys and sorrows of life.
Through the joys and sorrows of life.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
Through laughter and tears.
Through love and through tears.
I will love and cherish you.
I will love and cherish you.
I give you my pledge.
I give you my pledge.
Thank you, Lisa. And at this time, may I have the rings, please? Thank you very much. Now, these rings will seal this commitment. And they're not only tokens, but symbols of the very love and devotion that the two of you are expressing here this evening. And my hope is that in each and every day, with the two of you wearing these rings, may they constantly remind you of that promise and pledge that you've just made to one another. And in time, the rings themselves may lose beauty, but I hope that the two of you would not only value, but take honor in wearing these rings for what they truly represent. And through your friends and family, the beauty will shine through you both, and the two of you will always remain a wonderful example to all. So Alex, and taking a ring, as you place it upon her ring finger, if you would please repeat. With this ring.
With this ring.
I seal my promise.
I seal my promise.
To be your faithful and loving husband.
To be your faithful and loving husband.
And I am so honored.
And I am so honored.
To call you my wife.
To call you my wife.
Thanks. Perfect. Thank you, Alex. Lisa. As you place the ring upon his ring finger, if you would please repeat, with this ring.
With this ring.
I seal my promise.
I seal my promise.
To be your faithful and loving wife.
To be a faithful and loving wife.
And I am so honored.
And I am so honored.
To call you my husband.
To call you my husband.
Thank you, Lisa. Wonderful. Now at this time, I'll ask for the two of you to step over and behind the unity candle.
Okay.
And as I mentioned earlier, the two of you have each had a separate path that has led you to this very point. And it's the individually lit tapers that are representing your individual lives. And in lighting the center candle, you will not only be uniting yourselves, but that of your families as well. So I'll ask for the two of you to take a hold of your individual taper, and if the two of you can light the center candle at the same time, which is also symbolizing the creation of a new journey with new memories. And if I could ask for the two of you to turn and blow out your individual taper. Perfect, thank you. And I'll invite you guys back to the front. Now, Lisa and Alex, if you love someone, you'll be loyal to them no matter what the cost. You'll always stand beside them. You'll always love and trust them. And you will stand your ground in defending them, no matter what. Now there's a short poem I'd like to repeat for the two of you. And it is in part. And it simply says, I love you, not only for who you are, but for who I am when I am with you. I love you for taking your hand into my heaped up heart and passing over all of those weak or frivolous things you can't help but see there, but drawing out all of the good, the beautiful, and the radiant things that dwell within. Now I know the future may hold some ups and downs for you both, but if the two of you would always remember to look back at all the moments, all the memories, and all the very reasons that brought the two of you here today. Like I had mentioned earlier, I then have no doubt that your lives together will be everything that you want it to be. So it certainly has been a joy to be part of this celebration with you here. And I think I could speak on behalf of everybody else. And the 4th of February, a day that will now mark your anniversary. The two of you have each showed your intentions by the exchanging of your vows and the exchanging of your rings. Therefore, with the authority vested in me by the state of Nevada, it is my honor and my privilege to now be able to pronounce you as husband and wife. Alex, you may now kiss your wife, sir.
Finally.
They will now have their first dance.
Congratulations.